Okay, so we were discussing about the ways how the friction can be reduced. Okay, in this what we were reading? We were discussing about the ball bearings. Now, what is ball bearing or what are ball bearings? If you open your pedal, not your pedal, means the pedal of your bicycle, okay? If you open the pedal of the bicycle, you will see some small silver color, you know, small round this thing, objects are there. Okay, these are ball bearings. Now, why it is so? Because just to give an easy movement for your pedal. Okay, now this I gave the example of just your bicycle. It is there in many vehicles, almost in the wheels I'm talking about. Okay, so when I'm talking about ball bearings, so how the structure is, you know, just this is the axle. Okay, now this is the covering of that. Now here comes the ball bearings. Okay, and then this is the inner surface. This is the inner surface, actually this one only. Okay, inner surface of the wheels. Now see, this is the axle. Okay, and this part is totally filled with the ball bearings. Okay, this means this is ball bearing only, this one. Okay, so very small rounded structure. And what is this? This is the inner part of the wheel. That means it is in contact with this ball bearings. So you know what is the aim of doing this? So that the movement become very easy, the movement become fast, easy. Okay, now if you know these ball bearings, okay, this part is oiled. When this part is oiled, so what will happen? You know, the friction will become like it will reduce more, isn't it? So first of all, the circular surface, and on the top of that, if it is oil, that means again a lubricator is added. So what will happen? The friction will reduce to a greater extent. That is the reason why the use of ball bearings is there, why the ball bearings are used. So this is what ball bearings. Okay, it reduces the friction, and when it is lubricated, or when oil or something, you know, we have read about the lubricators, is added, so what will happen? Again, the friction will reduce to a greater extent. Okay, now what can be the other thing which can again reduce the friction is, you know, air cushion. Now, what is the meaning of air cushion, children? So, what's the meaning of air cushion? Air cushion means what? See, if two surfaces are there, okay? If two surfaces are there, and between these two surfaces, lot of friction is created, okay? Lot of friction is there. So, if the friction has to be reduced, so we know what has to be done. If air is filled between these two surfaces, okay? If air is filled between these two surfaces, then what will happen? This air filled between two surfaces will act as an air cushion and won't allow the two surface, okay? Two surface where the friction was there, won't allow the two surface to come in contact, and it will again very useful to reduce the friction. Okay, one second, I'll tell you what is there. Now suppose two surfaces are there, and between these two surface lot of friction is there. Okay, lot of friction is there. Now if air is filled between these two surface, okay, if air is filled between these two surface, it will act as an air cushion. Okay, and it won't allow the two surface to come in contact. Like this is a two surface, and here if air is filled, so what is happening? The two surface are not coming in contact. Okay, and thus the friction is reduced. So what can we write in air cushion? If there is more friction between the two surfaces, it can be reduced by filling air, as it won't allow. It means who will not allow? Air will not allow. Okay, as air won't allow the two surfaces to come in contact. Okay, it will not allow the two surfaces to come in contact with each other. Okay, so this is what air cushion. Okay, air cushion means what? Here the air acts as an air cushion. It doesn't allow the two surfaces to come in contact with each other, and so thus the friction can be reduced. Okay, now what can be the next thing? Next thing to reduce the friction is what? Anti-friction metals. Okay, now what's the meaning of anti-friction metals? Anti-friction metals. Okay, now what is the meaning of anti-friction metals? See, whenever two steel things, okay, whenever two surfaces are sliding on each other, and both the, suppose if we take the example of steel, both the surfaces are of steel. That means there are two surfaces and both the surfaces are made up of steel. Then what will happen, you know, the friction which will be produced will be very high. The friction produced will be very high. So you know what is done? Then one surface is taken, or you know, the lead surface is taken, and instead of taking the steel surface. So you know, there are certain substances, certain, you know, I should say combinations, where the if they are used properly, the friction can be reduced. Okay, and, you know, it is not that completely the lead, complete lead is taken. Again, a form of lead, like I should, the best way to say is the alloys. Okay, so what is this anti-friction metals? There are certain metals or alloy which reduce the friction. Okay, which reduce the friction, and so it is used in place of other metals. So how can we write this anti-friction metals? When steel slides over other steel surface, okay, when steel slides over another steel surface, large amount of friction is created. Okay, when steel slides over other steel, large amount of friction is created. Okay, but you know, when in place of steel, okay, so it can be replaced it can be replaced by alloy of lead. Okay, it can be replaced by the alloys of lead. Why it can be replaced? Because this lead surface, it gives a lesser friction in comparison to the steel. Okay, so instead of using two steel surface, if it is replaced by the alloy of lead, then the friction which is produced here will be reduced, it will be less, and that is the reason why the alloys of leads and such kind of other combinations are used. Okay, now what can be the next or just we have discussed everything. We have discussed here now ball bearings, air cushions and also anti-friction metals. Okay, by the use of, you know, by making the changes in the shape, that means streamlined shape, then by adding of lubricant, okay, by even the by polishing the surfaces, okay, then by use of ball bearings, even, you know, by changing the surface, like if you take the circular things, then what happens, the friction get reduced. Okay, and filling air in between the friction, the surface where the friction is there, and again by use of anti-friction metals. So all these are the ways how the friction can be reduced. Now we'll talk about something else. See, now I'll just, let me clean this board. Okay, so now we'll talk about the fluids. Okay, now we have discussed this. What is the meaning of fluid, children? Fluid means what? When, like when we talk about liquids and gases, these can be known as fluids. Okay, fluids means what? It includes both the thing, liquids as well as gases. So I will write about fluids now. Okay. So we were talking about fluids. Now, what is the meaning of fluids? Whenever we talk about liquids and gases, okay, in, like we are talking about, when we are talking about both the things in combination, it can be known as fluids. Okay, that means liquids can also be known as fluids and gas can also be known as the fluids. Okay, so now here we are talking about the friction in fluids. Okay, while discussing somewhere in the chapter, we have discussed that the friction which is there, which exists between the two solid surface, is quite high than the friction which is there in the liquid. Okay, but liquids also, they also have their friction, like friction can also be observed or can be seen or can be faced in the liquids and gases. It is there, isn't it? But when I compare the friction which is produced between the two solid surfaces, okay, is, will be always higher than what, between the solid and liquid. I'll tell you an example. When I'm talking about the friction between the car and the road surface, okay, that means both the surfaces are what, they are solids, so the friction is very, very high. Now the second example, if I talk about the boat moving in the liquid, so boat is what, solid, and it is in contact of the liquid surface. So solid in contact of the liquid. Okay, now next example, if I talk about an aeroplane which is flying high in the sky, that means what is there, the liquid, the solid, that means aeroplane, is in contact of the air, that means the gas. Okay, and when we compare all these three frictions, the friction which is seen, the friction which is observed between solid and solid will be the highest one. Okay, so first of all we will write that, I will write here like solid and solid. Okay, so what example can I take? Car, solid surface. Okay, car and road. Okay, the next example can be taken of what? Like aeroplane, and where does it flies? It will obviously fly in the sky, that means what will be there? Air, that means what will be their gas, that means which kind of surface is this, it is for solid and gas. Okay, so which kind of surface was the first one? It is a solid and solid surface. It is what? Solid and solid surface. And the next one is what? Solid and gas. And third one which I can talk is food, okay, moving in water. So what will be here? It will be solid in combination with liquid, isn't it? So when I talk about these three surfaces, the friction here the friction observed here will be maximum. It will be what? It this surface, the friction will be maximum, okay, but it doesn't mean that here in these two cases the friction will not be there. No, even here also friction will be there, okay, but little lesser than the here, that means solid solid surface, okay. Okay, so now we are talking about these two, either the liquids and the solid, or either the gas and the solid. Now when I talk about these kind of friction, you know, the friction which is there, or when a friction is created between these kind of surfaces, means what? Fluids. When fluids exert friction, then it is known as drag. Okay, drag force means what? In simple language, the friction created by fluids is known as what? It is known as drag. Okay, so we are talking about the friction in fluids. So the friction in fluid is known as drag. Friction in fluids is known as drag. Okay, so when the friction is created due to the liquid or the gaseous surface, then it is known as fluids. Then when the friction is produced due to fluids, then it is known as drag. Okay, now I'll write the proper definition of the drag. Okay, I can write in somewhat different way also. So the friction exerted by fluids is called as drag. Okay? Okay. So how this drag can be reduced? Can we reduce the drag also? Okay, what is drag? The friction which is created or exerted by fluids is known as what? Drag. Okay, how it can be reduced, children? See, reduce. Okay, first is shape, streamline shape. Okay, streamlined shape always reduces the friction. When you talk about the aeroplanes or ships or boats or any vehicle which runs in the liquid or in the air, so always you will find the shape is what? Streamlined. Okay, why streamlined? Why does it reduce the friction? Because it is sharp, it is like this. Okay, so it has got great, this shape has got greater capacity to cut the air pressure as well as the liquid pressure. Okay, now when you talk about the streamlined shape in nature also, the shape of the fishes, take the shape of the birds, okay, all these animals also have streamlined shape. Why is it so? So that the air and the pressure of the gas can be, or the air can be cut down, can be reduced. Okay. So streamlined shape is very, very important. It reduces, the friction as it has greater capacity to cut the pressure of air and liquid. Okay, it reduces the friction. Streamlined shape always reduces the friction, as it has greater capacity to cut the pressure of air and liquids. Okay, so first point, first way how the drag can be reduced. Now what is drag? Drag is the force which is exerted by the liquids and the gases. What are liquids and gases known as? These are known as fluids. Okay. Okay. Now what can be the second way, children? How the drag can be reduced? What are the second way to reduce the drag? Okay. So second, we'll talk about the density of the fluids. Okay, density. Okay. Now I'll give you one example. Okay, you have a toy. Maybe you take it. Okay, I'm giving an option. Maybe submarine, maybe ship, maybe boat, whatever toy you have. Okay, and it has to be moved. Okay, the toy submarines or the toy boats or ship, whatever we are talking about, it has to be moved on the surface of the liquids. Okay. The first example, the first in first case, you have to move that in the water. And the second case, you have to move it on the melted chocolate. Okay. It sounds quite interesting that we are sitting in a boat and having melted chocolate is there and just we are eating it, isn't it? But now, please come out of this. We are talking about the drag. Okay. So, the first case is what? When you have to move your toy submarines into the liquid. And the second case is what? When you have to move your submarines into the melted chocolate. Now you only decide, you only think and tell to yourself. You cannot tell to me, you cannot cannot discuss. So you just discuss among yourself only. So where the friction will be more, children? Where the density of the liquid is more. That means when we talk about the second example, where the submarine has to move in the melted chocolate, there the density is very high, isn't it? It is quite thick. So it will be quite difficult for you to move your toy submarine into the chocolate, melted chocolate, isn't it? So what does it prove, children? That greater density give rise to greater drag force, isn't it? Greater density give rise to greater drag force. So how this thing can be reduced? It cannot be reduced always. The density of liquids cannot be increased and decreased. It's not in our hand, but just this is a factor. Okay, this is a factor which also affects. If the thickness is more, then then what will happen? The friction will be more. Okay, so this was the second case. Now when I talk about the shape, when I'm talking about the streamlined shape, if you have observed, if you have noticed, when a swimmer goes in the swimming pool to swim, if you have observed his position, he takes his position like this, isn't it? I do not know much about the positions as I am not a swimmer. But if you have observed, you know, even once if you remember, the position is like this, okay? So what they are trying to do, you know, they are trying to make, okay, they are trying to bring their body into streamlined shape, isn't it? Then they sit in a particular position, okay? They sit in a particular position, again they bring their hands like this. What they are doing, again they are trying to bring their bodies in the streamlined position, okay? So again, while swimming also, if the streamlined position is maintained, then it gives the lesser drag force will be observed or will be faced, okay? And if you know about this, you know, if the swimmer has to jump, okay, into the water, and if the position is not correct, you know, it hurts very badly, okay? Sometimes maybe on the stomach, and you know it, but it hurts very badly. I know this much, that it hurts, okay? So for jumping into water, into the swimming pool, a particular position has to be taken. That position is just to cut the force of the water so that the minimum, okay, that means your body like won't get hurt. So this was all about fluids. Fluids exert pressure, that is a separate thing, but here we are talking about what fluids exert, what, like friction also, okay? The friction exerted by fluid is called as drag. It can be reduced if the shape is streamlined, okay? And it also is affect, this drag is also affected by the density of the liquids, isn't it? If the density is more, then the friction also or the drag also get increased. Also, not also, it get increased, okay? Now we'll talk about the other topic. Okay, now that small topic is there, which I think will be, I'll be able to write over here. I will talk about first of all the spring balance, okay? What is the meaning of spring balance, children? Okay, spring balance is an instrument, okay? It is an instrument which has spring in it, and here the readings can be taken. Here one hook is there with which it can be attached to any body, okay? Now suppose if I have to talk, if I can attach it to, you know, a box, a brick, okay? So this instrument gives what? It gives the reading of the weight, the force, actually the weight, how much weight is there, how much force has to be applied to move this weight, okay? So what it is a brick or a box. To this, the hook of this, I have tied over here, I have taken a thread and tied over here, and I have, this is the hook, okay? So to the hook, the thread or anything can be attached, okay? Now, you know, in general, the weighing machine, you might have seen, children, in the clinics when you go to the doctors, and you may also have seen this weighing machine in the, you know, railway platforms. You know, might have also measured your, might have taken your weight, you know, because it is a human tendency, you know, whenever we see a weighing machine, we just try to jump and we just try to take our own weight, okay? So what exactly spring balances are? Spring balance is just an instrument which help us to take our weight, okay? When we talk about the smaller, when I'm talking about a smaller spring balance, it can be used to any object. And when it is pulled, okay, when it is pulled, the reading comes over here. What does it say? It says that this is the weight of the substance and this much is the force which is required to pull it. Now, I'll continue with this. Why I discuss spring balance? Because we will talk about spring balance in the next topic. So now we will talk about the next topic.